Hello dear students, I hope you all are good at your home. So today we will learn about eclipses and its types. So first of all, I will start with the eclipses. What are eclipses? As in my last video, we will discuss about shadow. So it is related to shadow. So the eclipses, the moon, the earth and other planets cast their own shadow in space. Eclipses are the example of formation of shadow in space. There are two types of eclipses, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. They are classified depending on the position of the sun, moon and the earth with relation to each other. So let's learn about solar eclipse. When the moon comes between the earth and the sun and when all three are in straight line in a solar eclipse is formed. For the part which lie in the umbral region, it is a total eclipse. For the part which lie in the preumbral region, it is a partial eclipse. A solar eclipse occurs only a new moon day. Do you know the diamond ring effect observed during the total eclipse is said to be one of the most spectacular scene ever to be witnessed. And this is the diagram of solar eclipse. Solar eclipse occurs when the moon shadows fall on the earth. As you see in the diagram, the moon comes in between the sun and the earth. The greenish part is called total solar eclipse and the grayish part is called partial solar eclipse. So this is the diagram of solar eclipse. So before starting the partial and total eclipse, we will discuss about umbra and penumbra region. So if the source of light is white, two shadows can be seen. One shadow is completely dark, called umbra, in the center. The other is a partial shadow, called the penumbra, which surrounds the umbra. The umbra doesn't receive any light, but the penumbra receives light from the source of light. So on the basis of these two reasons, umbra and penumbra, the eclipses were further divided into two types, total eclipse and partial eclipse. Now let's start with the total solar eclipse. Occurs when the moon completely blocks the view of the sun. The inner shadow of the umbra of the moon fall on the earth. This is called total solar eclipse. As this name indicate, the totally view of sun is blocked by the moon. That's why this is called total solar eclipse. After total solar eclipse, let's learn about partial solar eclipse. Occur in the area of the earth where the penumbra hits. Part of the sun is visible from the earth. Only the part of the sun is blocked, not safe to look at. This solar eclipse is not safe to look at. Now lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse occurs when the earth passes directly between the sun and the moon. The earth casts a shadow on the moon. A lunar eclipse can happen only during the full moon. This is because it is the only time when the earth, sun and the moon are directly lined up with the earth between the moon and the sun. So students, this is the diagram of lunar eclipse. As you see in the diagram, earth comes in between the sun and the moon, and you also see a circle around the earth. This is moon's orbit, means moon revolve around the earth, as you know.
And in the diagram also, you also see the umbra region and penumbra region, which I already discussed in this video. So this is the diagram of lunar eclipse. So what is total lunar eclipse? Total lunar eclipse occurs when the moon is in the earth's umbra. Can be seen anywhere on the earth that the moon is visible. Partial lunar eclipse, it's occur when the moon does not fully move into the umbra region of earth.